Annmarie, what do we need to know?
Good morning, Nara. What you need to know is all pale, all male, isn't cutting anymore, at least for Goldman Sachs. David Solomon issued this ultimatum in Davos. The biggest underwriter of IPOs in the U.S. will no longer do business with a company lacking a director who is either a woman or diverse. So this comes after July. And if a company wants Goldman, the board must have at least one person who is not white, male, or straight. And next year, the bank will raise the threshold to two diverse directors. Now, Goldman said the decision came after it learned that more than 60 U.S. and European companies in the last 2 years went public without a woman or a person of color on the board. Fred Folks, he's a management professor at Boston University. He says for Goldman and Wall Street, this is a seismic change. But Nara, we cover diversity and equality here a lot at Bloomberg, and questions will remain. How will other Wall Street firms follow Goldman on this? Will they not? And more importantly, whether this actually represents the high watermark for diversity, or is this just the beginning to bring greater representation to boardrooms and C-suites around global Wall Street around the world?